Hello, Tay Forgers. In this video, I want to show you how to implement generic functions in BERS with Unity ECS system. So let's dive in. Okay, so let's start by creating an enemy type enum. We'll use it in this tutorial to assign a type to an enemy, and in the next video to determine how much damage a given enemy has dealt. Let's add three values: none, moving and jumping. Next, we need to implement our enemy component data. In this component, we want to add enemy type field, which will allow us to handle damage dealt by the enemy in the system. Of course, we also need to modify enemy affering. We simply add serialized field for the enemy type with a getter. Then we add enemy component data and pass the type from the affering class. Okay, it's time to go to the Unity editor. We want to set types for moving enemy and jumping enemy prefabs. So let's do it. This will allow us to distinguish our enemies. After that, return to IDE. Select player component data. In the next video, we want to set player health, that's why we need to add public float health field. Obviously, it is necessary to set this variable initial value in the player affering. So let's add serialized field private float health with a getter. And remember to pass value in the player baker. Great! Now we can focus on the player detection scripts. Let's begin with player detection component data, in which we would like to add enemy collision filter. Then, inside player detection affering, let's create new serialized field, physics category tags, belongs to, and collide with for our enemy. As before, we need to create a collision filter consisting of both tags. Don't forget to pass enemy collision filter in player detection baker. Okay, go back to Unity, recompile. Let's go straight to the systems, select player detection game object. For the enemy belongs to, set player, and for enemy collide with, enemy. This way our player will collide with enemy and receive damage. Fantastic! It's time to return to Rider. This system still uses obsolete aspects. Let's just add enemy collision filter to it. Finally, we can implement player detection system. Let's create a member variable for enemy collision filter and assign it in the onCreate method. Remember to pass it in the player detection job. It's time to implement our generic method. First of all, we can delete handle collectible collision detection method and create new private void handle generic detection for many hits. Of course, with BERS compile attribute. It is generic function, so let's add T and prepare parameters local transform, player transform, box geometry, and collision filter, collision filter. The most important part is to specify T generic parameter, so let's write where T unmanage, because it is struct, I component data. Without where, we cannot use ecb.addComponent entity new T later in the code, because somebody can pass for example a class, but addComponent only accepts unmanage code, which is I component data. Now, prepare native list distance head heads with allocator.tempJob. We can write bool is collision equals our overlap box method with player transform, box geometry, ref heads, and collision filter parameters. If is collision for each every hit and add component via ECB. Our component is new T, where T is determined in the where block. At the end, don't forget to dispose hits. Next, we need to call this generic method, so let's adjust handle collectible collision detection to use handle generic detection for many hits. And also do it for enemy detection, but with parameter player damage component data, which we'll create in a moment. Note the way parameters are passed, especially inside T notation. Great, we have prepared our enemy detection. Now let's prepare player damage component data and player damage system that we will use for debug.log today. And later we'll use them when actually dealing damage. So let's create player damage component data, which is order flag for the player damage system. Next, prepare player damage system. It is iSystem struct with burst compile and update after type of player detection system attributes. Firstly, let's implement onCreate, onUpdate, and onDestroy methods. With burst compile attribute, create new entity query, damage entity query variable. Inside onCreate, we want to assign our damage entity query via systemapi.querybuilder. With all player damage component data dot build. Don't forget to add state.require for update damage entity query. Then in the onUpdate function, let's cache damage entities via toEntity array with allocator.temp. Just for now, I will add debug.log damage and dispose damage entities array. Okay, let's go to the Unity, select main scene and press play. Start game and collide with enemy. As you can see, our enemy detection is working properly. In the next video, we'll focus on the damage and health logic. I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon, where you can get the exclusive code, all models, materials or code used in this series, and access to early available content. Link in the description. Thank you for your time. I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.